is crashing on the shores of our hearts. Wave after wave of divine love is crashing on the shores of our hearts. 'Cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. And wave after wave of ecstasy Jeffrey. Hello, Jeff, my ecstatic brother Babu. Ecstatic heart, Jeff. Wave. An ecstatic heart, Brooke. Ecstatic. Ecstatic divine child of the light. Oh my gosh. There we are, nothing less. It's not even worth one thought for the rest of this life to think of ourselves as any other way but ecstatically and blissfully. One with the one. Wave after wave of divine love is crashing on the shores of our hearts. 'Cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of ecstasy. Love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of ecstasy. Hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. You and me, we're hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. Across the sea, hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. You and me, 'cause love keeps rolling. Eternally. Ryan, Jamie boy, hearts on fire for sure this morning. Don't even consider yourself a human. Not even one more idea of that, okay? We're just going to have the flames of divine love burning all the whole time this morning on the love line. And all ideas, everything that is just part of the outer crust of the duality, of the delusion, is going to be burned, baby. Wave after wave of divine love. So just as to feel the love, feel the force, Luke, feel the love. All day long, every day, every minute, feel, don't think, feel the love, feel the force. It can only be experienced through deep, pure feeling, also aka intuition. Wave after wave of divine love is crashing on the shores of our hearts. Wave after wave. Just don't listen with your head to the music. Put yourself into your heart and feel. That's the whole missing link on the planet. That's it. We're not feeling, and we're so afraid to feel because our feelings aren't positive. We have to start from where we're at today and embrace the feeling you have now. But at least go there, accept it, embrace it, and then eventually love it. But feel, baby, you must feel. Feel. 'Cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of ecstasy. Love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of ecstasy. so we're hearts in ecstasy. Hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. You and me, 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 'cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. One more round, okay? Good morning, Bob, Babananda. Woo! Wave after wave of divine love keeps crashing, crashing on the shores of our hearts. Wave after wave of divine love keeps crashing, crashing on the shores of our heart, 'cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of ecstasy, love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of ecstasy, hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. You and me, hearts in ecstasy, across the sea, hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. You and me, hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. You and me, 'cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Love keeps rolling, rolling in ecstasy. Love keeps rolling, rolling in ecstasy. Hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. You and me, hearts in across the sea, hearts in ecstasy, ecstasy. You and me, 'cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Next breath, please. Feel, feel. Have the idea that you want to feel love. Why would you have other ideas? Oh, breakfast, maybe you had breakfast. Oh, gonna see the kids today. Why would you have those ideas? Honestly. And just keep them on the surface, and there's nothing going on in the heart except at a condition affection or condition love that's built into the human condition. Now, what about this divine condition that we are in to feel the love of ages? To feel the light that we are all immersed in. Huh? That's a feeling deal, man. So let's just receive a breath and visualize a big tsunami love wave coming in, and exhale, let it crash on the shores of your heart. This is the meditation breath right here. Inhale, big tsunami love breath. Feel, feel. This is not an idea, man. This is an experience. Exhale, feel the love crashing on the shores of your heart. It's all about the intuitive imagination. Inhale. It's all about you awakening your soul reality. Exhale. This is soul. We're practicing experiencing who we are. Inhale, receive another breath. It's a tsunami wave. Visualize that wave. It's peaking. It's feathering. Exhale, and it's crashing. A new experience of divine love on the shores of our combined hearts, all right? Inhale, another tsunami wave of divine love. Visualize, it's cresting, cresting, cresting. It's feathering, feathering, because the offshore winds. And exhale, let it crash. This new wave of divine love crashing. And the experience of you with your intuitive imagination. Close your eyes for a moment, everybody, and then just continue this with one breath after another, with no other idea in your mind, with no other plans in your heart, because in 1 second, God could pull you out, and you would be experiencing this if you practice experiencing it now. There are many mansions in the inner worlds. There are many mansions of consciousness right now, and you can choose which one you want to go to. But if you ever want to have some relief from your mind, some relief from your emotional state, from relief from your conditioned human state, what you call love, what you call family, what you call everything else that you're doing, beautiful, beautiful, but but man and woman, not before the truth. It's only because of the truth that God has given you the gift of form and the gift of another body and the gift of family. So wave after wave, let it crash on the shores of your loved ones, on the shores of the hearts of your loved ones, please. Would you do that? Why are they outside of you? If you want them to be happy, if you want them to feel love, if you want them to fulfill the destiny of their hearts, dear, my friend, soul sister, soul brother, brother love, sister love, we must experience it first in our heart because they are in our hearts. Be the change. Feel the love. Put them in the love of your heart right now. Don't struggle with your meditation. Don't think that the thing you're going to do later is better than this. Let them feel the love. You can change the world by experiencing divine love in your heart. Breath after breath, wave after wave of divine love crashing on the shores of our hearts. Do you feel them there? Do you feel them experiencing what you're experiencing? Have you pulled in the soul rebels into your heart? Have you pulled in the rest of the world into your heart? It's not outside your heart. Be blind to the world outside. See clearly what's in your heart. Who looks inside to the heart awakes. Who looks outside dreams. Wave after wave of love is crashing, crashing on the shores of our heart. Love is rolling. Rolling eternally, wave after wave of ecstasy. We're hearts in ecstasy, you and me. Hearts in ecstasy across the sea. Hearts in ecstasy, you and me. Cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Receive a big breath. Open your eyes if your eyes are closed. And exhale, sigh it out, sigh it out. You just repeat real fast after me. I feel the love, you say. I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening, then when we say the awakening, hit your heart. Awakening, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love. Hit your heart. Awakening, your turn. Awakening, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening, awakening, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening, awakening, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love, feel the love. Awakening, awakening, I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening, awakening, oh I. I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening, awakening. I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening, awakening. I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love. You guys are singing, huh? Awakening, you say, awaken, hit your heart, huh? I feel the love, you go, feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening. Awakening, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening, awakening, I feel the love, I feel the love. Awakening, awaken, all of us. Oh, I feel the love. Awakening, yeah, awakening. Good morning, Amy. Welcome. We have a big morning of loving, wave after wave, crashing on the shores of our hearts, divine love. I know we get isolated. I know we struggle in our meditation, but you know what? Get used to it, man. This is going to always be the pulls and the extremes in this duality. So don't make a big deal about it anymore. We got to shift our focus to feeling the love, to, you know, feeling the breath, to feeling that we're not just an isolated heart, that our hearts are one. So if I can feel love in my heart, you score, baby. Ryan, Bob, you score, baby. Your family scores, baby, as soon as you feel divine love, the higher love. Not just the thought of some affection for this outer form. That's fine. It's beautiful. But don't forget the formless infinite that is the form in the first place. We are all formless infinite in the first place, the second place, the third place, in the middle, and at the end place. All right? Because today we're going to talk about unruffled peace. Now, how are you going to achieve unruffled peace? How are you going to go into that neutral heart? For starters, the neutral heart, the neutral feeling, the unbiased, the unemotional, the uninvolved, the detached neutral feeling. You tell me, you got a better idea? Probably not. This is why you're here. Ivana, you couldn't have come on this love line. There's a bunch of guys on here. And Amy. A bunch of guys jumped on because we're in desperate need. We're in desperate need of pure feeling. So Ivana, would you please help us out here? Really, we are not a male. We're not a female. We're an ageless soul. But anyway, thank you. We're just feeling. We're awakening our feeling. We're awakening, embracing whatever feeling we have, good, bad, or ugly, accepting it, embracing it, and loving it. And if we can love it and love it and love it, poof, poof, here comes the love, baby. Here comes the love. I feel the love, right? I feel the love awakening. But it's going to take intense practicing of feeling the feeling nature with unbiased, with unprejudice, with neutral attitude and trust and faith in your soul that the soul is pure love. And it's going to be steady as we go, meditation every day, walking meditation. Lindsay Russo will tell you all about everything I've just shared. In fact, she won't whisper a word. She'll just emanate love. Because she has us all in her heart. She'll just have a big smile like a big wise woman. Like a wise woman. There's nothing more powerful than a smiling wise woman and a smiling wise man. And we're going to hear Yogananda say those words this morning. All right, so as I share now this Gita verse 15, chapter 2, page 203 of Yogananda's God Talks with Arjuna, because we've been on this mental toughness, aren't we? Haven't we? We've been on, you know, a few verses about rising above the sensations, the invading armies of sensations, which try to have you perceive a conditioned feeling around those likes and dislikes. Well, we're almost to the end. Two more verses. Then we're going to have some background on the Gita. Then we're going to roll into chapter 1, verse 1. But by then, we'll have shored up, we'll have sharpened our swords, right? We'll have maybe have a little deeper, steadier approach to this, whether sitting meditation, walking meditation, changing diapers, you know what I'm saying, visiting the grandchild. That's all awesome. That's all beautiful. But it's number two, baby. Number one is your divine awakening of love in your heart, okay? Don't worry, that's not putting second things second. It's putting the second things now first in your heart, because those people are only going to change when your heart changes and uplifts, okay? You got that? I mean, you want so much happiness for family and friends and hopefully for this world, right? But there's not one iota happiness that anyone outside of you is going to experience it until you do. There's not one iota of pure love that anyone in your life, your children and your children's children are going to experience until you do. And if you really want that to go off the charts and you'll get busy having that experience of pure love night and day in the castle of love. Because desire, my great enemy, has given me lots of trouble, Lord. desire, and we're going to hear about that today. That enemy I will deceive, remaining in my castle of peace, in my castle of love, night and day, in thy love, O Lord, night and day, wave after wave of love, crashing on the shores of my heart, crashing on the shores of our hearts together. I'm going to be blasting you today, friends. Did you feel it this morning? I have you in my heart. I'm not waiting for you to change. I'm not waiting for you to decide anything. I'm not waiting. I don't want to. I'm not waiting. So I'm going to feel as much as love as I can feel today and tank up. Tank up, because you're in my heart and I'm in your heart. Tank up. Somebody's loving with you today. Someone, huh? Somewhere is always loving us. Somehow it knows our name. Yeah, someone is definitely loving us today. So let's let that happen through us, huh? Okay, chapter 15. Oh, flower. Here we are. Thank you, Lindsay, for joining. Woo! Big time stream this morning. Big moment right now. It's the biggest one you've ever had in all your incarnation. This breath is the greatest one you've ever had. This moment of just going into your heart and feeling that wave as a big tsunami, infinite love wave, and it's crashing. And don't worry about what you're going to do later, because it's crashing on that idea of later that you have in your head. Don't worry about someone else, and don't worry about this and that, because all of those are just thoughts. But if you bring your thoughts into your heart and let wave after wave crash on your heart, it's going to crash on those thoughts. It's going to crash on the things that you're going to attend to later. You're going to get there, and the love is going to be still there because you have it here and now. Oh, man. We're on a roll, baby. Oh, flower among men and women, Arjuna, and I've been calling the divine feminine Arjuni. He or she who cannot be ruffled by those or these contacts of senses with their objects, who is calm and even-minded during pain and pleasure, he and she alone are fit to attain everlastingness, who are calm and even-minded during pain and pleasure. So, you know, I mean, we get attached to family, and the last thing we want to have them is to feel any pain. But it's part and parcel of this duality. And we'd like them to feel good, so maybe we give them too much, right, of these outer sensory pleasures. But you're going to see, and behind the rose bush of every pleasure is the rattlesnake of pain, and behind every pain there is pleasure. But we're talking here, Krishna is talking here, we need to rise above the pleasure and the pain. So who is calm and even-minded during pain and pleasure is alone is fit to attain everlastingness. Remember, it's spirit that's inside these forms. It is infinite spirit in the heart of every creature. So let's really, really feel and love and meditate on that truth, so we're not so scared, we're not so attached, we're not so fixated on the outer, okay? So Yogananda goes on to say, that blessed being who is unchanged, listen to this. Hey, you know, you sign up for a yoga class, you sign up for a 200-hour training, nobody has a clue. It should be a new instruction in that. Words like this, what you are saying, if you want to be a yoga teacher, well, you can sign up for a yoga class. It's not near as intense as signing up to be a yoga teacher. We should take the word teacher off. We should say to wake up to your immortal nature, 200-hour training, but don't ever tell someone they are going to be a teacher of anything after 200 hours. You know what I'm saying? And for these reasons, because these are the practices that we should be doing in the 200 hours, rather than to move this foot here and to have this intellectual concept where your mind is just fully, absolutely full of indigestion of all this left brain so-called knowledge that you can parrot then after 200 hours, okay? We have a love force revolution going on in soul trainings now. Wait till you hear about the one I got coming up, Lindsay Russo. Ha! I'm a part of yours, you're going to be a part of mine. That blessed being who is unchanged like the anvil under the hammer stroke. Oh, God, are you kidding me? You know, because that anvil of your feeling, emotional feeling and attachment gets one stroke of a heart attack, one stroke of bad news about somebody, you know, and God forbid, that it's going to be someone's close to you, are you going to be able to take that with some equanimity and then cry your heart out? Are you going to be able to take that and have some refuge for your mind and heart in the soul of you? Are you? We got to prep, man. This is soul and heart boot camp training time on the planet. So that blessed being who is unchanged like the anvil under the hammer stroke of trials, the one who is even-minded during both cloudy winter days of pain and pleasure, and sunny springtime days of pleasure. Winter days of pain and sunny springtime days of pleasure. The one who calmly absorbs trials into herself as the sea quietly swallows rivers. See, we're not running. We're not pushing aside. We're allowing the duality to bombard us because there's no escape from it. There's no escape from the three guna bombardment. Everyone's making the dark side wrong and this and that. What does Krishna advise? You know, be soul, take refuge in your soul. Make that your heaven. Come into that transcendent place of you. The spirit you, the spirit soul, and there absorb all the trials, all the bombardment, as the sea quietly swallows rivers. He and she are then ordained by the gods to attain the eternal kingdom. All right? So let me just give you a few ideas from Yoganandaji. You don't realize Yoganandaji. If we did, this would be our first nature. We don't realize that we have a true guru and a true teaching. And probably more important, you don't realize that you're true. You are the true guru. You are the true teaching. Who is you? The soul, the spirit soul. He said, I want to ply my boat many times across the gulf after death and return to earth's shores from my home in heaven. Oh, this is a famous poem of his. I want to load my boat with those waiting, thirsty ones who are left behind and carry them to the opal pool of iridescent joy where my father distributes his all desire quenching liquid peace. Oh, I will come again and again, crossing the million crags of suffering. With bleeding feet I will come a trillion times if need be, as long as I know one stray brother, one stray sister is left behind. He's come down for you and me. He's here for you and me. The guru. Your guru is the soul. The soul is the guru. The soul is here always for us. And then he said, I want thee, dear God, that I may give thee to all. I want salvation that I may give it to all. I want, free me then from the body, from the bondage of the body, that I may show others how they can free themselves. I want thine everlasting bliss that I may share it with others, that I may show my brothers and sisters the way to happiness forever and forever in thee. I have a song for that. I'll play it for you sometime. The basic principle of creation is duality. If one knows pleasure, he must know pain. So we already discussed that, right? If creation had manifested only heat and only cold, only sorrow, only pleasure, human beings would not be irritated victims of the pranks of duality. But then, what would life be like in a monotone existence? Some contrast is necessary. It is man's and woman's response to duality that causes our trouble. Your response to the good and the bad, the pleasure and the pain, and anything and everything in between is the cause of all your troubles. So long as one is slavishly influenced by the duality, she lives under the domination of the changeful phenomenal world of phenomena. Of constant change. Oh, got a cold today. Not feeling good today. My boyfriend just left me today. What? Is there going to be any peace, unruffled peace in all of that if you buy into that? So man's egoistic feelings expressing as likes and dislikes. So then you have likes and dislikes around all this phenomenal change that you're buying into. People say, this is life. This is life. So I'm just going to accept the phenomenal change that are bombarding me, and I'm going to like some of it, I'm going to hate the rest of it, right? And people accept that, not in the way that we need to accept it as a duality and then rise above the gunas and rise above the likes and dislikes instantly, quickly as possible, soon as we can. They just accept the bombardment. So our feelings expressing as likes and dislikes are entirely responsible for the bondage of the soul to the body and earthly environment. Solely responsible. Our response as likes and dislikes is solely responsible for all your suffering in your body and in the environment around you. Good morning, Jolene. All right. Our cognizing intelligence is a mere registrar of experiences. So our disinterested intelligence, our disassociated, you know, true nature as wisdom mind, you know, we just register the experiences in a disinterested academic way. It records the events of a dear one's death or the birth of one's child alike in the same honest, prosaic manner. Whereas intelligence simply informs human consciousness about its loss of a dear friend, feeling marks and classifies the experience as distinctly painful or as distinctly pleasurable. These psychological twins, man's feelings, the twin snares, they get you every time. These psychological twins, pleasure, pain, are the feelings have a common father. These twin snares have a common father. They spring from desire. My great enemy surrounding me is giving me lots of trouble. Oh, my Lord. Sri Yukteswar Yogananda's Guru. That enemy I will deceive, remaining in my castle of peace, night and day, in thy joy, O Lord. Castle of peace, soul refuge, make that your heaven. Every moment, every way, you're going to see that if we let down our guard in this sensory world, we're going to have a very, very, very difficult time of tremendous self-made pain. Because all of it depends on how you are going to perceive it. So all of that, pleasure and pain, have a common father, desire. Fulfilled desire is pleasure and contradicted desire is pain or sorrow. They are inseparable, just as night follows day, and as the earth revolves around its axis. So pleasure and pain revolve on the axis of desire. You know, if you search your heart today, you have a desire, you're going to have some food, you're going to see some people, you're going to have a Sunday, whatever that Sunday is. Does that take the place of divine love? Does that take the place of truth? Does that take the place? Well, then you're just going to be having your desire, your likes and dislikes are going to revolve around that axis today. Something goes wrong, big dislike comes in, your feeling nature is an irritant to the peace of your soul, there goes. You'll be ruffled feathers. Woo! Ruffled feathers, right? Ruffled feathers, those peacocks, man. You know, proud as a peacock, baby. Proud to dislike something. Proud to like something. Happy kind of when you have something going your way. Really freaked out. Why is this happening? Trying to analyze it, you know, when it doesn't. Man, get over it. Get over that. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. You can expect it. You're going to feel lousy after you feel good, okay? So what are you going to do about it? Are you just going to accept that truth? Or are you going to be a soul rebel? Are you going to be a heart on fire? Are you going to get deeper and deeper committed to truth? Huh? I can't wait for my training to come out. I can't wait. Well, I don't need to wait because I'm in training. And you are in my heart, so you're getting the training. So if it manifests, great. But I'm giving you, sharing with you all my happiness, all my joy, all my experience. And I barely have begun. So desire is produced by indiscriminate contact with the objects of the senses, okay? This expressing its likes and dislikes of the ego, desire creeps into the consciousness of one. Here it is. Desire is a creep. It's energy plus will. Anything that, take all your mortal desires and put it into one supreme desire. I told Jessie yesterday, I left her a voicemail. I said, listen, you know, I know it's tough for you right now. It's tough for everyone, and it's going to be that way as long as we're in this physical reality, right? I know it's tough, but listen, and God knows it's tough, and it ain't necessarily going to change, okay? But there's one thing only that is going to deliver you from being absolutely depressed around that, and that is this moment of saying to the beloved, I love you. That I have in my heart. Whether it's really tough and I'm broken down and falling to pieces, or I'm like, wow, this is what's going to happen. I'm excited, right? That you can say to the beloved, no, oh, there's only one thing that I can do in this world, and that is love you, my beloved. That's it. I am not capable of anything else, but the one thing I am capable of is loving you incessantly, beloved, okay? So be watchful enough, because desire is a creep, and it's going to creep into your consciousness of what, if you are not watchful enough in governing the reaction of your feelings, the creep is going to creep into your consciousness if you're not watchful enough of your reactions to your feelings to various experiences. In other words, we're implanting love in our heart. We're implanting a desire for love in our heart. We're implanting that the beloved lives in our heart. So it's not that we're leaving the heart without a purpose. We're just not allowing the negative feelings and this and that and just being smothered by them and back and forth like a ping pong match. No, we're implanting the desire to awaken the divine love that's a seed, that is an immortal seed, a pure wave after wave of divine love crashing on. We're planting that desire in our heart. So that's what we're wanting to experience. That's why we'll accept this depression. That's why we'll accept and embrace and love what is this anxiety. This is why we will accept and embrace and love that we just screwed up so-called again, that we just left our guard down and we just went into the sensory world, and it takes you all the way down every time your vibration lowers, every single time, okay? So just know that. And then when you're down and out and crying again and you know, taking days, I'll tell you, the secret of self-mastery is how fast you can pick yourself up, brush yourself off, and get back into loving, okay? So when that creeps in and you have a reaction to those very experiences in the world, it is a condition the ego imposes on itself and is therefore detrimental to your even-mindedness, my friend. It is detrimental to allow these sensations and to allow these various experiences to knock you off your kilter. One day, we're not going to be knocked off. As Yogananda said, we need to stand unshaken amidst the crash of breaking worlds. It's simple, right? It's simple. We're going to stand unshaken because we're going to have that indomitable resolve that we're going to stand unshaken. We're going to be able to let go of family. We're going to be able to let go of our biggest things that are coming our way, or the things that just destroyed our happiness. We're going to just drop it because it's not us. And we're going to get entrenched in the castle of peace and love in our soul. And it won't matter, as they ask Krishnamurti, why are you so happy? Because I don't care what happens. All I know is that this moment is a moment that, this is what I say, is I love you. I love you. Master, I love you. I know that. And that's all I know. I am incapable of everything else. If you want me to do anything else other than love you, then you have to give me the wherewithal. You have to give me your amazing grace. You have to give me your master's touch. clay, I'll change. You will be changed into gold when you touch me, sir. All right. Whatever has its origin in desire is a disturbing element, and we're talking a desire that isn't the supreme desire to say to the beloved and be in love right now. Just take all those lesser ones. You can't destroy them. Just use their juice. That's where I get all my juice. I'm channeling all my desires for all the things that could really destroy my happiness. I'm just using that juice to be happy, you know? Because when you say to God, I love you with all my mind, that's every thought. I love you with all my heart. That's every feeling and every desire in your heart. I love you with all my strength. That's saying that, Lord, I'm going to love you purely, invisibly, intangibly, divinely, with my body. And everyone gets that one a little mixed up. Oh, I love you. Let's have sex. Really? Yogananda said sex is about far from pure love as the moon is from the sun. And it's one of the most outgoing, earthbound desire experiences you can have, okay? So when you tell God, I love you with all my mind, heart, strength, or my body, you're making love purely with a pure mind and a pure heart and in consciousness. Does that make sense? And with your whole being. So whatever has its origin is a disturbing element. For desires are like stones pelted in the calm lake of consciousness. So every time you put God second or third or fourth, or later tonight, then you have that meditation right before you go to bed and it's a sleepitation. Whenever you put God way down the totem pole, in that case, you just are throwing, pelting stones that are pelting into the calm lake of your consciousness every day, creating ripples, change. Attachment to pleasure, aversion to pain, both destroy the equilibrium of the inner nature. You know, you being obsessed with your diet, your vegan diet, and every little thing you're going to eat is as being obsessed to a heroin. It's the same thing. Same thing. Obsession, oh, I hate that, to I really like that, same thing. Okay. Recognizing the inseparability of the opposites, the masters of India deem that even pleasures being temporary are harbingers of pain. Remember, every pleasure you have today, when you leave the true pleasure, you know, Krishna says true pleasure is that pleasure which endures. It's not what we're going to describe here. It's the pleasure of your awakening soul, which is the ecstasy, the source of all true pleasure that endures. The true, unchanging, permanent happiness, joy, peace, love. Huh? The masters of India deem that even pleasures being temporary harbingers of pain. Pleasure that comes like a brief straw fire to illuminate a dark heart. Oh, I'll do anything just to have a little pleasure now because my heart is so dark, with a message of joy because this pleasure will give me a momentary straw fire of joy and then suddenly dies down, only deepens the original sorrow. So if you wonder why this chronic depression, this chronic anxiety, this chronic, you know, getting moody if something didn't work out and overly excited when something starts to seem to be promising because other people may say something that you think they're going to follow through. No one's ever going to follow through. Not on you, baby, until they can follow through on themselves. Only you can follow through now by following through, by getting through and into being reachable as a soul, letting the mind come in, the desires, the trials. Remember that anvil? Boom, boom, boom. All that stuff, just a hammer hitting the anvil. Boom, boom. Ah. What's the problema, baby? Ah, I found myself. I'm in my soul. Boom, boom. I don't care what happens. All that booming is a dream experience anyway. Boom, boom. You're just even keel. You are unruffled peace. So those little straw fires of going outside your inner sanctum of peace is going to create even more sorrow in your darkened heart. This is why the Gita teaches that the excitation of pleasures should be avoided. Hello, Raphael. You made it, brother, live. This is Raphael Ishida, everybody. Welcome this amazing soul. And Vicky, amazing soul. And if Steve's on, I can't see the comments that you guys make, but if Steve's on, more love than ever. And Steve, here, I got a suggestion. Just me to you, brother. Get on more. Get on more. All those moments in between, if you ain't really like what you feel when you come here, we got to be on the stream more. That's why I'm giving my life to streaming. This is why I'm giving my life to you, Steve and Vicky and Raphael. Don't you feel that? Huh? I'm giving my happiness away today because I'm happy today. I'm giving my love away. But listen, I don't lose anything. I get more happiness and love by making sure I share it with you. How do I share it with you? I carry your heart in my heart. So we're all together on this. I'm not a me and you're not a you. We are a we. And I thank you too for any effort you make to be in your heart of peace and consider that we are in there too with that peace. Would you please share a little of your peace? You know, and if the only thing that you can share, good morning, ZZ, is your headache again, is your problem again, is your excuse again, we'll gobble that up. That's just a little river that will flow into our one big oceanic heart and soul. We'll absorb it with love. So, but do feel that you're connected to something here, kids. Please get off your isolation. So many days in a row, so many minutes in between, and all this other stuff that seems important, that's the ultimate ripoff of this duality and delusion. You know that, right? Huh? So, the Gita teaches that the excitation of pleasure should be avoided as avidly as one seeks to avoid the unpleasantness of pain. Only when feeling is neutralized toward both opposites. So we got to at least get neutral around it. But I'm telling you, the secret of getting neutral is to have more love in your heart, because love is going to be the thing that takes you up, lifts you up when you're down. That's going to pull you back up after you have fallen and let yourself down. It's going to bring you back up, because the faster you can get back to the truth, the better off you are. And that is a master. A master gets right back. Instant forgiveness, instant compassion, gets right back. Doesn't take days upon days upon days of feeling bad about oneself. And then all this laziness, when you can get right back into the soul stream, get right back with your rebels. We are on the front lines, and just wait and see when we start chapter 1, verse 1. We are on the front lines of every breath and moment in duality. We are on the front lines of the most ferocious Armageddon battle, epic love and war story ever. Only when feeling is neutralized toward both opposites does one rise above suffering. It's very difficult indeed to hurt an ever-smiling wise man, an ever-smiling wise woman. Right? Oh, you got to admit that I smile a lot. Huh? Well, I'm not. Hey, listen, you know why I am the way I am? Because I am the biggest baby, the biggest sensory addict, the biggest of all the things that would, you would say are the things that we need to overcome. I was the epitome of the biggest baby addict, whatever, complainer, depressed. I was it. So I just need recovery. I just need my regular joy meetings and my love meetings, because, you know, I can't miss a meeting, you know. You know, it shouldn't be like, I am an alcoholic when you come to those meetings. That's not a good affirmation. You know, we are Delusions Anonymous. So I am an immortal soul. I am pure joy and happiness. I am light, wave after wave of crashing on the shores of my heart. But guys, I'm here at this meeting because I forget that and I feel like shit. No, excuse me. I feel like crap. I mean, no, forgive me for saying that, but I only went to the human for a second there, okay? Right? It should be that way. And I come here because I don't want to feel that way anymore. I need to know my true self, right? This is why we are each other's, our DA sponsors here. I promised myself, not promised myself, but I don't want to say those words. But sometimes just the human comes out. My dad was the ultimate cusser. So I'm doing pretty good, right? In a family where I had a dad that's the ultimate cusser. Love my dad. He's with me now. All right, in order to attain mental aboveness, we must practice a neutral attitude to all earthly changes, at least neutral. But I'm talking about wave after wave of divine love is crashing on the shores of our heart. We'll end with that song again. We're crashing on the shores of our hearts. Oh, that's going to take care. That's going to put you in neutral and then start putting you, kickstart your heart and putting you into soul gear, baby. Huh? Love. Yeah, you can go for neutral. You can try to use your mind to neutralize the mind, but love. Remember what I told Jesse yesterday. You can rest assured that all of these old feelings and old habits are going to stay hovering around you, pounding at you, right? But you have something more powerful and more beautiful that is going to obliterate all of that eventually in the fastest way ever. And that is, I love you, though. I love you. Your intimate relationship with Divine Mother. I love you, Divine Mother. I love you. Hold me now. I can't live a moment. You have to hold me. I'm your little babe, my helpless babe. Just hold me, Divine Mother. Help me, Divine Mother. Please help me to forgive myself, Divine Mother. You can be that. That is our purpose here on the planet. It's not these outer things of change. If you go for an outer result, for an outer thing in a world of change, we're going to be very, 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 very groundhog, and we're going to be very, very, very drained of energy at the end of the day. All right. Many people, so you might have this reason. If I cultivate a neutral attitude, how could I enjoy life? And then Yogananda says, the answer is a matter of logic. Even though we enjoy pleasure after pain, still it seems hardly reasonable that in order to appreciate health, we should first undergo accidents and disease. Because I hear a lot of people, well, I'm in pain right now, but how could I experience the joy if I'm not in pain now? You're going to hear in just a second that that is not the right attitude for a soul rebel. So if it seems hardly reasonable that in order to appreciate health, we should first undergo accidents and disease, or that in order to enjoy peace, we should first experience excruciating mental suffering. You know, I counsel couples who are getting married all the time, and they say, we fight. And I go, wait, you haven't got married yet. Let's get over that. No, but we fight. What? Oh, but then the makeup, you know, because then the makeup is, you know, then we make up. Why? Why? So in order to enjoy peace, we should first experience excruciating mental suffering. Friendship may surely exist between two persons without their first indulging in enmity. The mortal way, therefore, of taking life as it is, of accepting as inevitable the periodical incursions of pain and pleasure, is not the right way of carrying on this mundane existence. The saints have found that happiness lies in a constant mental state of unruffled peace. The saints have found that happiness lies in a constant state of unruffled mental peace. During all experiences of earthly dualities, a changeable mind perceives a changeable creation and is easily disturbed. The unchangeable soul and the unruffled mind, on the other hand, behold behind the mask of change the eternal spirit. Hello, where's Waldo? Hello, Krishna, it's you right here. It's me right now. Underneath this mask of me feeling not so good or worthy or deserving, under this mask of something didn't go my way or it's going my way and I'm overly excited or underly depressed. It's not that. Hello, where's Waldo? Where's Krishna right now? We'll be able to see behind the mask of change when the unchangeable soul and the unruffled mind are united together. The man whose mind is like an oscillating mirror beholds all creation as distorted into waves of change. But the man who holds his mental mirror steady, mental mirror steady, mental mirror steady. How is our mental mirror steady going to happen? Wave after wave of divine love is crashing on the shores of my heart. All I know is my mind is in my heart experiencing this ecstasy of my heart, wave after wave. That's how we have a steady mental mirror, my friends. All right? See, aren't you glad you're a bhakti? Aren't you glad you're on a bhakti stream and a bhakti soul and heart boot camp training? Love ninja style? So the mind who is like holds the mental mirror steady, beholds there not but the reflections of the soul unity God. We're just going to see Krishna. There you are, beloved. Here I am, beloved. I'm right here, right now. Hello, Christine. Through realization, not imagination, he sees that his body and all things are the condensed consciousness of spirit, the mind free of artificial excitation. Hey, become free of this world of artificial excitation and artificial pain inducing. Become free of that. Remain centered in the native state of inner peace and soul joy. Ha! So Yogananda then used, there's I guess a story of Ulysses, and he uses it to say that there's a deeper now inner state of peace. Meditation, that we need to go have deeper meditation so that the interaction of the sensory powers are quiet and unruffled as well. The interaction of our astral source conduits to our physical sensory powers are still and calm as well. But listen, this is good. We're almost done. With the guru-given techniques, the master's got you covered. It's going to change your clay into gold and your darkness to light. Remember, you have a true guru, my friends. Lay your life in that guru's hands, huh? Follow that guru's teachings. Love that guru most importantly, huh? Just love that master, just most importantly. So when by guru techniques, the yogi withdraws his attention and life force from the muscles and heart and plies his boat of meditation over the river of spinal electricity, because we're all withdrawing into our spine. Lindsay knows this. Zizi knows this. She's done enough yoga training to know that we're getting into our spine. We're retiring our consciousness into the heart. We're quieting the heart. We're quieting the mind. We're going into pratyahara, the interiorization of our consciousness into the river of spinal electricity. So when you start to be able to sense this inner withdrawal, this interiorization of your consciousness through love and love and love and right living and right thinking and all the things and practices that we are now sharing in the Gita, you find, like Ulysses of old, that the sirens of sound, touch, smell, taste, and sight, the sense sirens, take many forms and try to lure you toward dangerous waters. If the mind is impressed by these subtle sense promises, so you start to go deep in your life. You start to be more steady in your life. You start to have more real love in your heart. It doesn't have to be the physical, not even, I don't even call that love. Just call it sex or whatever. You can have a little mix. And Yogananda says there's usually a little mix of love in there. But usually, you know, as you get these sirens that want you to go out, these sense sirens, once you're starting to get more steady, that's going to be a battle for a while too. Remember, I love you, Master. I didn't do so good today. What did St. Augustine said? And if he's starting to get a little deeper before he really committed to the spiritual life, he said, Lord, give me chastity, but not quite yet. If the mind is impressed by these subtle sense promises, the soul boat of meditation enters a whirlpool of ignorance. The sincere devotee, however, finds that this lure of the senses does not last long. Hallelujah. It soon wears off. These sense sirens are only the last vestiges of prenatal tendencies long ingrained in the brain. The last vestiges of prenatal tendencies, and hopefully we're not adding fresh supplies of karma tendencies by our choices in this life, right? When we're trying to burn up, oh my gosh, who knows how much of these prenatal tendencies that have long been ingrained in the brain. We got to make sure all those old grooves are cauterized with our love and devotion, right? And our simplicity and our humble surrender, and then not create any new grooves of more restless desires. That enemy, we have to be watchful and govern what the input is coming in into us all day long, and then make some really wise choices by breathing that love breath. Finally, the devotee should ignore all these astral and mental impediments and keep her mind riveted to the pinpoint of luminous light in the center of the spiritual eye. I love that Yogananda, because he's saying, go home, baby. Don't get pulled off to any kind of a higher state of spirituality. No, just let that go. You keep going. Keep your mind riveted on the pinpoint of luminous light in the center of the spiritual eye, perceived between the two eyebrows during deep meditation. The devotee thus reaches the land of permanency, never again to be thrown back into the whirlpool of reincarnations and misery. Chapter 15. At pages 204, 205, 206, and 203 we had, of chapter 2. Let's just end with our song. I love you guys. I know that was a lot of reading, but you know, to me it's not just reading, it's receiving the blessings of the peace, of the Master's peace, the Master's Midas touch. It is to me. Just absorb it. You've absorbed it, Christine and Zarina and the rest of you who came online. And Stanley, I know you're busy with family. God bless you. I love you. And everyone else that has things to do, I know. But man, thank you for coming and just humbly surrendering everything you are just to absorb. No how-tos. Just this one. I love you. I love you. I love you, Divine Mother. Wave after wave of divine love is crashing on the shores of our hearts. Wave after wave of divine love, crashing on the shores of our hearts. All of our hearts are receiving the same cosmic love, all right? Hold that idea. Don't meditate alone, please. You receive a little love today. We're all going to have some. Please share. We're a big family. We have big meals to cook and share. Every positive we share, every negative we build a fire. We toss it into the sacred fire together, but we are we are inseparable. We are one. Love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of ecstasy. Love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of ecstasy. So we're heart, either heart ecstasy or hearts in ecstasy. We're hearts in ecstasy, you and me. Hearts in ecstasy across the sea. We're hearts in ecstasy, you and me. 'Cause love keeps rolling, rolling eternally. Wave after wave of divine love is crashing, crashing on the shore of our hearts. Love you, love you. I'm saying that to the beloved in you, the one beloved. I love you, I love you. I say that to the one beloved in the sky. I say it in this feeling I have now. I love you, I love you. I say it, and I receive it. Wave after wave of divine love crashing on the shores of our hearts, okay? Watch the replay, everybody. Have a beautiful, beautiful soul-sizzling Sunday. More love than ever to April, who just jumped on the line, but luckily we have the replays, don't we? We have the reruns. As Sandy wrote in a note, she said, you know, I used to love to watch I Love Lucy, all the I Love Lucy reruns, but now she says, I love these divine reruns. I love the Soul Rebel Gita streams. I love those reruns. Let's rerun eternity, okay? Let's rerun our happiness, huh? Let's rerun our ever-increasing, ever-new joy and what I call BBU, Burning Bliss Union. Ha-ha! We're the Love Force Revolution, Soul Rebel. Ninja Love Warrior Turtles, rub your hands. Let's do one ohm and celebrate. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh. I love you, 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 I love you. Hearts in ecstasy, you and me.